programs into this computer and stop yourself with something good that you know, by the grace of God, this is where I am going. You will reach there in Jesus' name. How did this Joseph have something good inside? Let's look at this. Genesis chapter 39, verses 2 and 3. Genesis chapter 39, verses 2 and 3. And the Lord was with Joseph. The Lord will be with you. And he was a prosperous man. And he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. And his master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand. Everything you do, the Lord will make it to prosper. You see, he did something. He was a doer. He was a doer. He wasn't a loafer, you know, just moving around, just hanging around, just loafing around, just having a nice time, just taking fresh air, just walking on the street, just playing ping pong. It wasn't just while in a way life, while in a way time. He was not killing time. Killing time is killing life. You know, there are some people, all they know how to do is just kill time. You kill time, you're killing life. You're killing success. You're killing progress. And you're killing greatness. Gather the times together. Gather the moments together. Gather the periods together. Do something. And he did something. He was a doer. You will be a doer in Jesus' name. In fact, if you look at, let me show you the words that we use about this young man. Let's look at that again. Verse 3. And his master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made all that he was. The next word. Tell me. Did. He made it to prosper in his hand. He did something. Do something every day. Crouch each day with progressive, positive, practical activity. Do something. Let's look at verse 21. In verse 21, and then I'll go to verse 22. And the Lord was with Joseph and showed him mercy and gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. And the keeper of the prison committed to Joseph's hand all the prisoners that were in the prison. And whatsoever they did, he was the, tell me the next word, doer of it. He was a doer. And I said, you put some practical programming into your system. That's for success. He did something, and he was a doer. Look at chapter 41, chapter 41, and look at verse 46. 41, 46. And Joseph was 30 years old when he stood before Pharaoh, the king of Egypt. And Joseph, what? Tell me, went out. Do you see that? He was not a lazy drone. He was not an idle, indolent young man. He did something. He went out from the presence of Pharaoh. And he went throughout all the land of Egypt. And so that's what we need to learn. If you're going to succeed and you're going to turn tragedy to strategy, do something. You know, look up here. Look up here. When a tragedy has taken place, there's something negative. It brings something to your life. What kind of tragedy? Let me just illustrate for you. You know, there are times you might miss a grade, a class, a session, an opportunity. That session what happened? You didn't make it that session. That's a tragedy. When that tragedy happens, it makes us generally inactive and passive. And then we sit down at home. What happened to you, Mary? I didn't make this session. It's so bad. And then you stay in that corner there, and you are not active, and the devil will be talking to you. Aren't you miserable? Aren't you fortunate? What will you ever do in life? Once you stay there, once you stay there, the devil will put in all his excreta on your head. And once you stay there, and then the tears will be coming out, then you will lose appetite. You will not be able to do anything. At such a time, when a tragedy has happened to you, the brain will go out of functioning. Your mind will not be able to see. The only thing you want to do is to cry and cry and cry. Tragedy. How do you turn tragedy into strategy? How do you turn setback into success? By doing something. Go out and do something. You see, Joseph, instead of sitting down in the corner of the house and crying and mourning and weeping and shedding tears, he got up. He did something. He became a doer. He was active. And then, as he moved around, he went out from Pharaoh's palace and he began to do what he ought to do. You will do something. I said you will do something. What did Joseph have? Because we are told, and God was with him. Number one, he had God. He had God. Say, I have God. I didn't hear you very well. You have God on your side. You have God with you. He is your Father. And Jesus is your Savior. And the Holy Ghost is your helper. He had God. You have God. Number two, he had a goal. He had a goal. He said, I'm still getting there. I have a dream and I'm going to achieve. I have a goal. I have a destiny. I have a place I'm going. He had God, number one. Number two, he had a goal. Number three, he had a guide. He had a guide. He had a guide. That's why Pharaoh said, can we find another man like this who has the Spirit of God? And the Spirit of God was there to guide him in interpreting those dreams, guide him in giving wisdom unto the senators of Egypt, guide him in giving instruction even unto Pharaoh. He had a guide. He had a guide. When you become born again, you are saved. After that salvation, there is sanctification. After that sanctification, there is the Spirit baptism, baptized in the Holy Ghost. And it is that baptism in the Holy Ghost that makes the Holy Ghost to become resident within you. And then he guides you and guides you and guides you into all the truths that you need to know. Number one, he had what? He had who? Number two, he had what? Number three, he had what? Number four, he had gifts. He had gifts. He had gifts. The gift of interpretation. You know, all those things, they work for him. They work for him. God, go, guide, gifts. He had all that. And they work for him. He brought his gift out. And you know, some people, they hide their gifts. They hide their gifts. I don't want anybody to know that I have any gift. I don't want anybody to know that I have any talent. I don't want anybody to know that I have any skill. I don't want anybody to know I have any ability. They hide their gift. But in the case of Joseph, he was not hiding his gift. And it was the gift. It was the gift that turned the tragedy into strategy. You know, he saw those two people in the prison. He said, why are you sad today? Oh, they said, because we have dreams and there's nobody to interpret the dream. And he had the gift of interpretation. He said, tell me your dream. Tell me your dream. Tell me your dream. I'll bring my gift out and it will work for you. Bring your gift out and your tragedy will be turned to strategy in Jesus' name. But you know, some people, I am sad today because of that. I will not use my gift. I dropped out in this session because of that. I'm not going to use my gift. I'm hungry, I'm thirsty, and there's nobody to supply my need. Because of that, I'm not going to use my gift. I lost that thing because I lost that thing. I'm not going to use my gift. Come on. It's when you bring that gift out in the midst of that tragedy, in the midst of that setback, in the midst of that problem, in the midst of that challenge, you bring out that gift, then it is a gift will turn your tragedy into strategy in Jesus' name. Yet number one, yet number two, yet number three, yet number four, yet number five, he had grace. He had grace. He had grace. Everybody say grace. Now, I'm going to do something for you. Write grace in another place now, in a corner somewhere there. And let's look at what grace is. Grace. Write it vertically. G R A C and E. Thank you very much. Are you ready? God's resources against cruel enemies. Praise the Lord. All those cruel enemies. I'm not worried anymore. You are not worried anymore. Are you worried? I said, are you worried? All those cruel enemies, God's resources against cruel enemies. Judah, Reuben, Simeon, Issachar, all of them. God's resources against cruel enemies. Potiphar's wife, Potiphar, everybody that said Joseph will not move on. Did he move on? I said, did he move on? Anybody, any cruel enemy that said you, sitting here, looking at me now, that said you will not move on. Will you move on? Of course, yes. Will you get to the top? Of course, yes. Why? Because of grace. God's resources against cruel enemies. You will trample over them. You will walk over them. And you will soon get to the place you need to get to in Jesus' name. Number six. Godliness, godliness. You know that Joseph, when that woman said, come, young man, come and do this. Oh, he said, no, people like us, we don't do that. People like us, we believe in holiness, we don't do that. We believe in sanctification, we don't do that. We believe in purity, we don't do that. Purer than diamond. Diamond, I'm supposed to shine in light. And I'm going to shine. I was shining when I was in my father's house. I was shining when I was on the road to Shechem. And I was going to my brothers. And even when they grabbed me and they took my coat of many colors, the sin to shine was still inside my heart. I'm still shining. And now in Potiphar's house, I'm not going to lose my shine. I'm not going to lose my salvation. I'm not going to lose my sanctity and sanctification just because I am here. I am destined to shine. I will keep on shining. Anybody going to keep on shining there? Where are they? I see you, your light will never go off. Godliness, he had that godliness within him. Number seven, grit, G-R-I-T. That means tenacity, that means standing there, that means holding on, that means keeping on, that means uncompromising, that means I am here, this is where I stand, and nobody will shift my focus. Yeah, grit. And that's the reason why eventually his tragedy was turned into strategy. And you have that already. You have God on your side. You have a goal you want to reach. You have a guide. He is the Holy Spirit. You have gifts, is the talents the Lord has implanted in you. And you have grace, and that's God's resources against cruel enemies. And you have godliness, and you have grit. You will make it. I said you will make it. What's point number three now? Positive progress towards the summit. We're reaching there. I said we're reaching there. I said, you are reaching there. Let's look at it now. Positive progress. We're looking at chapter 42. Chapter 42. I'm reading from verse 6. And Joseph was a governor over the land. And he it was that sold to all the people of the land. And Joseph's brethren came and bowed down themselves before him with their faces to where? To the earth. Now I'm asking a question. Did the dream